Bonjour, je m'appelle Dr. Tien et bienvenue à French 1311. Chapitre 2, leçon 2. Aujourd'hui, nous allons étudier les nationalités. Les nationalités. Hello, my name is Dr. Tien and welcome to French 1311. Chapter 2, lesson 2. Today we are going to study nationalities. Nationalities in French. Ça va? Très bien. To ask the question, what is your nationality? You will do that formally and informally. Okay, to ask the question informally, right? You're asking the question to somebody who is your classmate, somebody who is not older than you, somebody who is your friend. You do it this way. Quelle est ta nationalité? Quelle est ta nationalité? Quelle est ta nationalité? Informal way of asking the question, what is your nationality? Formal way of asking the same question. Quelle est votre nationalité? Quelle est votre nationalité? Somebody who is older than you, somebody you're meeting for the first time, right? So, quelle est votre nationalité? Formal way of asking the question. Quelle est ta nationalité? Informal way of asking the same question. What is your nationality? The answer will be, je suis. Je suis. You know, je suis from the conjugation of the verb être, right? Je suis. Je suis. And then, the answer will depend whether it is a female talking or a male person talking. If it's a male person talking, you use their masculine forms of nationalities. If it is a female, if the je refers to a woman, right, then you will use the feminine forms of nationalities. So before answering the question, quelle est ta nationalité? Quelle est votre nationalité? Let's talk about the countries and their masculine forms of their nationalities and feminine forms of their nationalities. Ça va? Très bien. So, let's begin with the countries, right? They will have, as we know already, they will have the definite articles in front of them. They will have le, they will have la, they will have an apostrophe, right? And then sometimes they will have le in front of them. Ça va? We know that from our lesson in chapter 1, right? Très bien. So, l'Allemagne, répétez, l'Allemagne, l'Angleterre, la Belgique, le Brésil, le Canada, la Chine, la Corée, l'Espagne, les États-Unis, la France, l'Irlande, l'Italie, le Japon, le Mexique, la Russie, la Tunisie, la Russie, le Mexique, le Japon, l'Italie, l'Irlande, la France, les États-Unis, l'Espagne, la Corée, okay? La Chine, le Canada, le Brésil, la Belgique, l'Angleterre, l'Allemagne, okay? So, look at the countries. Now you realize that most of the countries will have E at the end, right? La Corée, la Chine, la Belgique, l'Angleterre, l'Allemagne, l'Espagne, la France, l'Irlande, l'Italie, right? La Russie, la Tunisie. All of them are feminine. If a country in French, spelled in French, has E at the end, that country is la, right? Feminine, or L apostrophe if it begins with a vowel like l'Espagne, l'Espagne. Ça va? Okay, the only exception, if you look at that list, right, you see that here we have Le Mexique. It has an E, but it's masculine. That's the only exception in the list here, right? So, Le Mexique is an exception to the rule of countries with E's ending them being feminine, being feminine in French. Alright? Good. So, l'Italie, féminin. L'Espagne, féminin. Right? La Chine, féminin. Right? La Corée, féminin. La Belgique, féminin. L'Angleterre, féminin. L'Allemagne, féminin. La Russie, féminin. La Tunisie, féminin. Okay, let's talk about the nationalities now. The nationalities, right? Good. Now, Allemand here, Allemand will be somebody coming from Germany, Allemagne, right? So, we have the masculine forms and the feminine forms. A male person coming from the countries are here. Masculine and females coming from the countries are here. Ça va? So masculine, féminin. Okay. Allemagne, the country, right? Masculine, allemand, féminin, allemande. You add your E and then you will pronounce the D. Allemand, the D is silent, and then allemande, add your E and pronounce the D. Anglais, right? Masculine. Anglaise, add your E and then pronounce the S as if it is a Z sound. Anglaise. Berge, from Belgium, right? La Belgique. Berge, beige, because the masculine form has an E. Don't add this E, which is silent, don't add another E here. Is the same for masculine and feminine, right? Berge, berge. Now look at Brésilien. Okay, le Brésil, that's the country, masculine form is Brésilien, E-N at the end. Now if the nationality is like that in the masculine form, you will add another N before you add your E. Remember here, allemand, you just added your E. Anglaise, just added your E. With Brésilien, E-N at the end, add another N before you add your E. Brésilienne. See that Canadien has the same ending, E-N. So the feminine form will be Canadienne. All right? Two N's and an E, just like Brésilien, right? Brésilienne. Okay, now, la Chine, China, masculin, chinoise. You add your E to chinois, and then you sound the S. The S becomes like a Z sound, chinoise. Now, la Corée, Korea, right? Korean. The same ending, you see that it has EN, just like Canadien, Brésilien. So, you will have to double the N and then you add your E. So, Korean. The same thing with Canadien, Brésilien. Okay, Espanol, Spanish, right? The masculine form, Espanol, the same thing you did with Anglais, Allemande. You do the same thing here. You add your E for the masculine form to become feminine. So Espanol, Espanol, right? The same sound, but the feminine one has an E at the end. Now, les États-Unis, the United States, right? Nationalities, masculin, American, and then you add your E, right? And then the nasal vowel will disappear. American, 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 right? American, American. Okay, la France, français, française. The same thing with chinoise, right? Anglaise, so française, you add your E. L'Irlande, l'Irlande, okay? L'Irlandais, l'Irlandais, all right? L'Irlandaise, the same thing you did with français, française. You do the same thing with Irlandais, Irlandaise, okay? Now, l'Italie, italien, see the EN? Alright, so you did the same thing with Korean, Canadian, Brazilian. So, Italian, you double the N before you add your E. Italienne. Okay, Japonais. Le Japon. Le Japon, the country. Japonais. Just like Français, right? Anglais. Right, the sound the same. So you add your E and then Japonais becomes feminine, right? So Japonais, Japonaise, Japonaise. You add your E and the S is like a Z sound, right? Now le Mexique, no, that is the only exception to the rule where E's and then countries are feminine. Now, le Mexique is an exception, right? So the nationality, masculine one would be Mexican, just like American, right? You add your E, the nasal vowel un will disappear and it becomes Mexican, right? Here, the nasal vowel, Mexican. And here, Mexican, American, Mexican, add your E. La Russie, Russia, right? Just like berge, right? The masculine form berge. You see, you have your E already here. Russe, Russian. Okay? And the feminine form is the same, just like berge. Here we have russe. Okay, la Tunisie, Tunisien. North African country where French and Arabic is spoken, right? La Tunisie. Z sound here, La Tunisie. Tunisien, just like Italian, just like Canadian, just like Brazilian, right? So the feminine form, you double the N and then you add your E for it to become Tunisienne. Ça va? So the masculine forms, the feminine forms of nationalities. Now let's come back to our question. Quelle est ta nationalité? Informal. Quelle est votre nationalité? Formal. Your answers will be here. Je suis, right? You know, suis from the verb être, I am, right? Je suis. And then if the je is masculine, I said male person talking, it will be one of these male nationalities, right? It will be one of these nationalities that are male, right? If the je refers to a female person, then you choose one of these feminine nationalities. Ça va? So it depends on the person talking. So je suis anglais, right? I am English. I am British. Je suis anglais. And the je will refer to a man or a boy, right? Okay, good. Now, je suis, if the je refers to a female, then je suis anglais will become je suis anglaise, right? So, anglais, anglaise. If these were Germans, right, you will use je suis allemand, right, for the male person talking. For the female talking, you will be using allemande with the D at the end. You do the same thing with berge. See, they are identical. So there it will be je suis berge, right? For Canadians, you will say je suis canadien. And then the female person will say, je suis canadienne. People from Brazil, right? People from Brazil will say, je suis brésilien. Je suis brésilien. And the female talking will say, je suis brésilienne. Ça va? So you use the masculine forms depending on who is talking. If that person is a male, then you will use the masculine form, right? If the person talking is a female, then we use a feminine form. Okay, sometimes you will use the answer, je suis d'origine, all right? You want to specify where you came from. Maybe you are American, but you are originally from another country, right? So, sometimes you say, I'm originally from, right? So, you will say, je suis, like, je suis anglais, right? I am English, I am British, but I am originally from, right? Mais je suis d'origine. Je suis d'origine. Origine is feminine. So you use the feminine forms of their nationalities, right? Okay, so je suis d'origine. Use one of the feminine forms. Je suis d'origine italienne. Okay, italienne. Okay, so je suis anglais, je suis anglaise, mais je suis d'origine italienne, right? Origine is feminine, so use the feminine forms of the nationalities, okay? So you will say, je suis américain, oh, je suis américaine, mais je suis d'origine italienne. Mais je suis d'origine française. Je suis d'origine italienne. Je suis d'origine japonaise. Féminin. Ça va? Très bien. Now, if you are saying I'm studying, the language will be identical to the masculine forms of the nationalities. The language, right, will have the definite article, the masculine definite article always in front of them, the language, the definite article will be in front of them. If the language begins with a vowel, then you know the E will be dropped and then you put your apostrophe. So you have the L apostrophe in front of the language. All right. So for instance, if you are studying French, right? See the masculine forms of the nationalities? Just put le in front of the masculine nationality. And then you have the language, right? So, j'étudie le français. J'étudie le français. J'étudie le français. I am studying French, right? Okay, so you put le in front of the masculine form of the nationality. And then there you go. You have your language. J'étudie le français. J'étudie l'anglais. Okay, here you know that anglais begins with a vowel, voyelle, and then we have dropped the E in le, and we have put apostrophe here. So that's why you have L apostrophe. It is still masculine, right? So j'étudie l'anglais, put le in front of the masculine nationality, and then you have your language, right? Here, of course, you can say j'étudie le mexicain because it is Spanish that is spoken there. So you will say j'étudie, right? J'étudie l'espagnol. J'étudie l'espagnol, right? You put that L apostrophe in front of espagnol, and then you have Spanish. Je suis mexicain, mais j'étudie l'espagnol. Ça va? And then when you are using parle, I speak, the articles will disappear. The le, the L apostrophe will disappear. It is only when you are saying I'm studying or I study as a subject that you will put le or L apostrophe in front of the language. When you are saying je parle, the language will, yes, the language, anglais, right? Anglais, espagnol, italien, japonais, russe, the masculine forms are written without their article. Ça va? So, je parle japonais without the article le, right? Je parle japonais, italien, et français. Je parle japonais, right? Italien et français, right? Without the le, like you did with I'm studying French as a subject, right? Très bien. Or, j'étudie l'anglais as a subject. So, here, let's come back to the nationalities. To ask the question, what is your nationality? Informally, when you're talking to a younger person, your friend, somebody of your own age, you will ask the question this way. Quelle est ta nationalité? If you are asking the question to somebody who is older than you, somebody you don't really know, you use the formal way of asking that question. Quelle est votre nationalité? Right? The answer is always, je suis. Je suis. And then you choose from the masculine and the feminine forms of nationalities. Right? Now, if the person answering is a male person, then you use the male form of nationalities. If the person speaking is a female, then you use their feminine forms of nationalities. All right, so you will say, je suis anglais, je suis anglais, je suis anglais. All right, masculine, that means that person talking is a man, a boy, right? It's a male, right? Je suis anglaise. When the feminine nationality is used, then it means that the je is féminin. Ça va? And then sometimes you will say, je suis d'origine. I am originally, right? And then you use the feminine forms of the nationalities because origine is feminine, right? So, Italien, for instance, here will be used. So, je suis d'origine italienne because origine is féminin. You will use the feminine form of the nationalities. Je suis d'origine anglaise. Je suis d'origine française. Je suis d'origine japonaise. Je suis d'origine russe. Je suis d'origine tunisienne. Like you would say, je suis français. I am French. Mais je suis d'origine tunisienne. I am French, but originally from Tunisia, right? Je suis d'origine tunisienne. Ça va? Très bien. Au revoir et à bientôt.